We will now take a more detailed look at projector settings and additional mapping control icons. For this purpose, I have deactivated the 3D grid and the projector positions by using the following two icons on the top right. One is called Show Grid, which we already know from the Screens tab, and the other one is Hide Frustum, which hides the projector frustums. This can be particularly useful for simple setups where you really don't need to be able to see the frustums and just want to move your screens as part of a different kind of workflow. Another interesting icon is Show Test Pattern, with which you can activate a test grid. Let us now take a closer look at the actual projector settings. Here we have the projector resolution, which you get automatically from the database, as well as brightness and contrast. You can also change the position by scrolling or entering new values, using basically the same options you would also find as part of the Screens tab. Rotating around an axis can also be done here. I'll reactivate the frustum to make it easier to understand and see this point. You could even change the size of the projector cases themselves, just in case you have to build some bigger structure around them in real life. Lenses are, of course, a very important topic too. All major lenses available on the market should be part of our database here, from wide-angle lenses to tele lenses, but you can of course also create additional generic ones. When using a generic lens, you can drastically change the throw ratio. But when using an actual lens available in the database, you will be limited by the properties of that particular lens. Of course, you can also see and work with both the vertical and horizontal lens shift here. In case of this particular projector, Panasonic GeoPro also shows up, since it has been directly integrated into PIXERA. It is basically an automatic black level adjustment tool. Last but not least, on the left-hand side, we have our project options. This is where we can switch between different projectors. By looking at the Live tab, you can find your PIXERA servers in the network with the available outputs, which you can then activate and allocate to individual projectors.